An ugly crash in Rancho Santa Fe crushes a car and sends live power lines sprawling across the street.
We want to get right to our tenders reporter, Mackenzie Maynard. Mackenzie, we're learning that SDG&E just got there to cut those power lines.
Yeah, and that's actually a very crucial part of this whole process because I'm going to point behind me. The car that's, you see the red vehicle right there. Well, when they crashed, they actually sheared the power pole and left it here lying across the road. So crews weren't able to make any type of rescues because there were live wires, which is obviously very dangerous for those rescue crews. So they had to wait about 20 minutes for those for SDG&E to shut it off. Once they were able to shut off all the power, then they were able to use the jaws of life to take the driver out of the vehicle. We're told he was conscious, but if you take a look at this video, he was taken to the hospital. We're told he has some lower body injuries from the crash. He was actually taken to the trauma center at Scripps La Jolla. They initially tried to actually air evacuate him, so they were trying to use the chopper to take him out, but unfortunately, because of all the rain, they weren't able to fly the chopper over into this area. But again, what we do know so far is that it was this one vehicle involved. Thankfully, that man is being taken to the hospital. It ended up being a little bit of a process, again, like I mentioned, because of those live wires. But that is what we're learning, again, taking a live look here at the scene. Obviously, a little bit to clean up here as you see that power pole still across the road and that vehicle still there. But we were told that no one else was injured. No one else was in that vehicle. For now, reporting live in Rancho Santa Fe, Mackenzie Maynard, 10 News. Yeah,
clearly a serious situation there on El Camino Real. We all know that El Camino Real is just a two-lane street. In some areas, very, very curvy. In this area, fairly straightaway section of the road, but dangerous and dark, not a lot of lighting. We're going to bring in Brian Schlonsky right now. He is in the Live Center. The other thing about El Camino Real, Brian, is it is miles and miles long. Tell us exactly where this accident is.
Yeah, Kimberly, so Camino Real, of course, barring a couple of breaks in it, goes way down. I mean, past the 56, past Del Mar, but where we are, we follow it all the way up. We're up in this area. They said near Rancho Santa Fe, Vio Gaviota is the cross street here. So just to show you this specific area on the map, and Vio Gaviota is more of a neighborhood street. It's a dead end street. You can't go any further on that. So you see very residential in this area, but also pretty wooded. So again, not talking about the southern portions of Camino Real. We are way up north here. Just to give you a layout of where this particular crash is, because we know there are a lot out on our roads right now, guys.